What are the goals of space exploration, specifically NASA today, and how has it changed from the time when you walked on the moon?
Oh boy, that's a loaded question. And my goals and the goals of NASA at this time may be a little different. Not in conflict, but different. I'm for exploration. We are certainly exploiting space with the use of the space station today. But in my day, we had a goal, we had a mission, we had a challenge, and that was to go to the moon. John F. Kennedy challenged the nation to do what most people thought was impossible, and do it before the end of the decade. And we did that. You know, don't challenge American people to do something and tell them they can't do it. Most people thought it couldn't be done, impossible, but history has proven otherwise. And today, unfortunately, I hate to say this, but unfortunately, we don't really have a mission, a goal. We're building some spacecraft. We say we might go to the moon someday without much enthusiasm. We say we might land on Mars, but there is no mission, there's no concrete goal and commitment by the nation, put it that way, to do that. On the other hand, I stand here having gone to the moon a couple times, lived on the moon, call it my home, and I will tell those young students today, as I do most young students of all ages, that we will go back to the moon because there is a reason. We will go to Mars, if for no other reason that curiosity is the essence of human existence. And as time goes, it won't be nearly as soon as I was hoping to be. And I'll probably be labeled the last man on the moon for some time to come. But in the next generation, those young kids in high school and grammar school today is a generation that is going to take us back and continue the exploration of the moon and indeed take us on to Mars. That will happen.
It's great that you're so optimistic. Could you explain sort of the relationship between the DLR, the German NASA, and NASA?
Well, you know, I happen to believe space is sort of an international magnet. It's bringing nations and countries together to, if you will, exploit their resources intellectually, financially, technologically. I've gotten a lot more familiar with the German Space Agency and with the European Space Agency than I have been in the past. And I think that, well, let me put it this way. When we do go to Mars, it's going to be an international visit. I think we're going to have young men and young women from many countries throughout the world cooperating together because, you know, space belongs, the universe belongs to all of us, and I think it's a natural evolution of our society here on Earth. If you look back and think about the fact over the years, space has allowed us to, just through communication satellites, to go to the Olympics, to be with the Pope, to do all kinds of things we never. It's brought us close together. We understand each other. I have a young granddaughter who is now touring Europe as part of a school project, and she's learning, getting exposed to people and places that were only in a textbook to her before. And how important is that? It's very important for the future of the world, quite frankly.
What advice would you offer to young people interested in pursuing aeronautics? What would you provide? I mean, you're meeting with young people today.
I tell you what, I'll go back to I had a dream as a kid. I'm a product of World War II. I was a young kid. I saw people flying airplanes. That's what I wanted to do. And little did I know, flying and the dream to fly airplanes, the passion I had as a kid would lead me to the moon, quite frankly. I tell kids to dream big, dream about things you don't think you can do, and then work hard. My dad used to say, do your best at everything you do. You're not going to be better than everyone at everything, but someday the best is going to rise to the top, and you very well might surprise yourself. So I happen to believe those dreamers of today are the ones who will become the doers of tomorrow. Find something you enjoy, make it a passion, and then cross that challenge border and look back and I tell these young people, there's young dreamers out there who will do things that neither you nor I or anybody listening today could have thought about doing.